In this tutorial, I'm going to show you ConvertKit secret hacks that nobody wants to talk about or nobody knows about. I'm also going to show you how to make money with ConvertKit email marketing. Hello, my name is Mark Daniels, a factory worker turned entrepreneur years back. My life was frustrating, difficult, and I was living paycheck to paycheck and borrowing money just to make ends meet. Now my life is absolutely blessed. I can do anything I want. I can travel anywhere I want. I can take a vacation anytime I want. I could buy anything I want. I think and I believe that everybody should have that right to do that. So that's why I am talking to you today about how to make money. Every time I went on YouTube trying to learn something, it was like somebody wants to sell me something. So there's nothing here for you to buy. I'm not gonna offer you a course or any of that. This is absolutely free. So I'm gonna talk about five ConvertKit secret hacks. ConvertKit secret hack number one, which is a sales funnel. A lot of people don't know that inside ConvertKit, you can do a hack that actually give you a complete sales funnel. I have been doing it for a very long time and you can too. ConvertKit secret hack number two, which is simply a digital commerce platform. Did you know that you can sell your own products, collect money, and deliver your product to your prospect or customer without even building a website and without hosting? Many people don't know that. ConvertKit secret hack number three, which is landing pages. You have access to beautiful landing pages that you can make a lot of changes to it. And also you have access to high quality images, which is thousands of them through third party, absolutely free. ConvertKit secret hack number four, which is simply integration with WordPress. You might ask, what does that mean? Why is that so important? Well, if you are selling any affiliate marketing product, you really want to use that because it's gonna prevent you from getting banned through your affiliate network or other social media as well. ConvertKit secret number five, which is the ease of use, which is free of frustration. What I mean by that, complexity is the enemy of execution. If things are too complex, it's gonna be very difficult for you to execute and take action. Many people have this issue, especially newbies, new people who want to sell anything online, whether through ConvertKit or something else, they're always having some issues. So that's why I'm gonna give you a tutorial right now to show you how easy it is. And who's gonna do that tutorial for you? It's gonna be Pat Flynn. If you don't know Pat Flynn, he is one of the most successful entrepreneurs online. He also the advisor of ConvertKit. So let's go ahead.
Here we are in the dashboard of ConvertKit, and here on the home front, you could see a lot of different things like the chart for subscriber growth over time. You can even see purchases if you have them. But I want to show you just how simple it is to create a landing page and a form. If I go to the landing pages and form signups area and hit create new, I can either pick a form to just drop into my website super easy, or even if you don't have a website, you can in fact have ConvertKit host a page for you to begin to collect emails. So for example, you could choose between a whole bunch of different templates here. I'm gonna choose this first one, Abby. And then all I have to do is just customize this. I don't need to know any code or anything. And you might be like, oh, well, where can I get some images? I'm just gonna click on this image and choose an image. And what's cool is it is integrated with, first of all, your Instagram, if you wanted to, or Unsplash, which is a free tool built into this where you can select, for example, if I'm promoting something related to, you know, email marketing, I'm just gonna type email marketing and I'll put, let's add this image here, why not? That's a little bit too big. Okay, let's click and edit that and let's make it a little bit smaller. I'm gonna crop this. This is all, again, within ConvertKit. So I'm gonna go here just because I want this little tiny segment. Done, done. Boom, there we go. Catchy headline goes here, some other text here. And as you can see, I could just simply click and change things around, insert cool copy here. Let's say I want to also add the ability to collect a person's name. Okay, let's make this the name field. So I'm going to hit custom field first name, and I want to move this around. Okay, let's move this up here, and I'm going to change the button text from subscribe to get instant access. Obviously, I would decorate this a little bit more, maybe have a different background image, go to general style, background, same thing, unsplash. This is where I would do, let's try email marketing again, and I'm going to add this one of like an office or something. There you go. Super easy to use. And then all I have to do is save and publish. And this is literally now on the internet. I'm going to hit share, click to copy, go to a new website. That is the link there. And boom, this is already ready for you to collect emails. So if you're coming out with a website very soon, or if you happen to be launching something very soon, you just simply use this to build as many landing pages as you would like. I'm going to hit new broadcast. It does give you a good record of previous emails that you've sent, click-through rates, all these sorts of things, and data behind them. But I'm going to send a new email. What's cool about this, and you'll notice this is a little bit more advanced, but this is, again, built into ConvertKit. Let's say that I only want to send an email to people who are in my podcasting course. So I'm going to go to subscribe to tag, Power Up Podcasting, all students, add filter. So now it'll be nearly 3,000 students. But I also don't want to send it to people who are also in my email marketing course. So tag, and let's do email marketing students. So email marketing magic. And you'll notice it's 2,744 subscribers. Add filter, it should be less. So that removed the people who are in my email marketing course. So now if I wanted to promote my email marketing course, and I didn't want to promote it to people who already had it, but I knew they were students of mine, all I have to do is hit next step. So that's how we determine who we send to. Now it's just super easy. Email marketing magic is now open. Then I can go to next step. I'm not going to send this because that would be very weird right now. But this is just an example. I can in fact schedule this for later. So I'm going to schedule it for tomorrow at 6:30 a.m. Pacific. Schedule broadcast. Or I can just save it for later. And that's another very powerful, easy thing to do.
Okay, and on number three, we're going to talk about something important, which is easy automation email sequence creation. Now, automation and email sequence creation are two different things, but it's very important to understand how they come in together. So let's go back to Pat so he can explain it a little bit further.
Automations. I'm going to talk about what we're seeing here in just a minute because this is the most powerful thing. But if we just go to sequences, we can get access to our traditional sequences of emails or autoresponders. We can see a lot of data behind a lot of the sequences that we already have. If we go to new sequence, they're very easy to create. Test sequence. And you'll see when I hit the sequence, we now have open an amazing tool. This is building out our autoresponder all in one spot. This will be the email that gets sent out immediately. So let's make this immediate. Then we're going to add another email that gets sent out, let's say 7 days later, a week later. Cool. Let's send another email and then another email. We can even use this filtration process like we did in the last section to remove people from receiving certain emails. So imagine that you have a whole sequence of emails, what's called sometimes a nurture sequence, and then you want to promote a product within that. Well, we definitely don't want to promote that to people who already have it. So even in the automated sequences here, we can have a filter that says, okay, do not send or matching none of the following. I don't want anybody who's in Power Up Podcasting to receive this email. Boom, add filter to group. Now, anybody who happens to be in my course already is not gonna get this email that says, get access to Power Up Podcasting today. Special deal, right? I don't wanna send emails to people who already have my courses about getting into my courses. And this is just one of the fun things about sequences. But let's take sequences to a whole nother level. If we go back here, we can now create what's called an automation. And an automation is a visual way to see what is happening from a high level perspective. And this is so, so powerful and such a good thing for even beginners to learn. So based on where people come from, we can tag them as such, however we'd like, and then send them to certain emails. So for example, I can go click new automation and we're going to create one together. Create automation. When a person joins a form or makes a purchase, let's click joins a form. And let's say they join this form here, which is our 100 email challenge. So I'm going to hit add event. Cool. I can also add another form. Let's say when a person purchases something, I want the same thing to happen. So maybe when a person purchases something from Stripe or makes a Stripe payment, sure, why not? So now when these things happen, I can have people be tagged. So I added an action, add tag, and I want to create a tag. Let's do email challenge tag. Okay. So when people come in from either of these places, they get the email challenge tag. Then what do we want to happen? I'm going to click plus. Now let's give them a sequence, right? So let's give them an email sequence right away. We can add a delay if we want. I can just go back here and add this too. Let's delay 2 days, add action. Then I want to give them the email sequence. Let's add that test one that we did before. Or I can add one. Test sequence two, add action. Now what's cool about this is I don't have to go back to sequences to go and edit this. I can just click here and it opens up right on the side. I get to see and remember where people came from, what they got tagged with, and then now know what emails they are getting. Let's send them this one immediately. Let's send the next one after that the next day. Sure, let's send another one a week after that. And I can always come in here and rearrange these emails, add more. Maybe I want a different one to be first. We can go from there. This is such a, this right here is what would normally cost thousands of dollars in other tools that I've used. And this is just here within ConvertKit. This is why ConvertKit is the best. Access to beautiful tools that are simple and easy to use, but very powerful and inexpensive.
Thank you, Pat. Now, in case you are wondering, how can I have access to all the stuff that Mark Daniels was talking about, all these hacks and secrets in ConvertKit? Well, you are in the right place, because inside my YouTube channel, it's full of tutorials that you can utilize, and most of it is utilizing ConvertKit and how to build a sales funnel from scratch, which is very easy hack to do. All you have to be is a subscriber. I'm going to be making more videos about how to improve your financial situation and how to make money either online or offline. You really don't want to miss them. So make sure to subscribe and hit that notification button. If you want to learn how I make over $700 from only 3 sources of income, click here and I will see you at the top.